Hello everyone, I want to spend a second to talk about flat networks. This is a term you hear a lot in our industry, threat intelligence, incident response, security, cybersecurity, however you want to call our industry. You hear this quite a bit actually. You'll hear either flat network or a big flat network, which is a reference to the kind of the size of the flat network. And I want to spend a second to kind of talk about this. Flat networks, I'm not going to dig into the weeds on this, but just know that this is a network where every station, everything that's on this network can kind of see everything else. It tends to go through only one kind of step, like in most houses, which is I've kind of put together a small diagram for you to see everything in your house, your TV, your iPad, your laptop, whatever. It all kind of goes through your home router, and everything on that network can see everything else. And why that's significant is it's flat. So a device in your kid's room where your daughter or son is on an iPad, that iPad can see the computer which you might be doing work on in your office or in the front room. Same thing for your TV, your printer, whatever it might be. There might be other things like that that are on your network, your security system, whatever else. They're all just kind of right next to each other, literally, logically. They may all go to the same router, and you may have them all in different IPs, but they're the same. And part of that's because they have something called a broadcast. I'm not going to get into the weeds. I'll put a couple links down there to talk more about how networks are configured. We'll definitely be touching on this a bit more in the future. But basically, in this case, a flat network, the key thing you need to remember here from a threat intelligence eye is that everything can see everything else. And that servers attached to this network are just the same. So if you have a server in your house, a SAN, or you connect the one and you've mapped a network drive, effectively everything can see everything else and contact everything else without having to go through a gateway, a router, or some other kind of security tool. So as you can imagine, as a threat intelligence concern, the biggest problem with this, among the fact that when you broadcast so widely and have a lot of devices on your flat network, everything gets super congested. It's like having a single lane road when you have two-way traffic and you have thousands of people trying to pass through it. You know, if it's one or two people, it's not a big deal, but the bigger that gets, you know, as you merge up towards hundreds and thousands, there's no way. There's enormous hold times on both sides. Is first you let one side go, then you let the other side go. If you've ever come up to a person who's acting as a flagman to, you know, halt traffic while they're doing some kind of construction, and you have to wait 10 minutes before they wave, and then they let a whole bunch of traffic go by, that's exactly what happens when you have too many devices on a flat network. It's not really a threat intelligence concern, but it's worth bringing up. More what we're concerned about is when we deal with a client or we deal with a customer that has a network that is a flat network, we immediately know that anywhere on that network that I can get in, or anywhere on that network where data can go out, provides access to everything on the network. So an attacker who can get on that printer, get on a TV, get on a server, get anywhere, right, through a web app that's running inside the network, anything that is all connected on this flat network provides access to everything else. And that allows for some seriously simplistic, easy propagation of malicious traffic. You know, as you can imagine, also lateral movement, where an attacker lands inside a network and figures out where they are and then moves around, is incredibly simple. My reconnaissance step is cake, because I can basically ping everything on the network and know where all the devices are. I can go right to the thing I'm really interested in. And if you're curious about why this is bad, I'm not going to imply that Target had a big flat network, but I am going to say that it's a very good use case where people kept crown jewel assets, which were crown jewels are the most valuable things in your company, let's say, or in your house, right next to some things that absolutely didn't make sense. In that instance, the vendors that were managing the HVAC system pretty much were logically right next to the point of sale terminals in the store. So where they were taking in money and doing transactions, that data set right next to them was accessible from the same HVAC appliance, and people who could come in from as a third party and manage that HVAC, they basically could see it. And so as you can imagine, that kind of contributed definitely towards them getting compromised and having all the trouble they did. So from a threat intelligence concern, knowing that a network is flat is critical. And there are some contrasts, and as we go on, I'll do light touch topics like this on things like hierarchical network and so forth. But just know that a big flat network, everything sees everything else, and it provides enormously simple access to do recon, to infiltrate, to take down. I mean, ransomware on a flat network will take it down quickly because everything can see everything else. It won't take it long to propagate out. So there you go, a very short topic. If you have questions, please send a comment. I'll add a few more links to talk a little bit more about network topology and networks in general. And if I can, I'll grab something that really goes into the Target details if you're interested in reading about an actual use case where this kind of activity led to a serious impact, if almost not, almost a downfall to target.